Welcome students. Today's topic is Introduction to Synopsis for Calcium. In this lesson, we are going to learn to identify spreadsheet applications, to identify the component of calcium, to enter data in calcium, to edit data in calcium, to format data in calcium. Calcium is a short form of calculator. So the question is, how will you calculate your daily expenses? You are either using the calculator or you can count on the finger, count on the paper by using the pen, and write the answer on the paper, getting the answer on the calculator of your daily expenses. So, for more complex numbers, we can use calculators, but still, calculator has some limitations. Like, in calculator, you cannot do the long mathematical expressions. If there is a change in the value, then again we have to redo the calculation. Like if you want to just change a number or just change the some particular calculation step, so you have to do the again full calculation on the calculator. So here the spreadsheet application got introduced because they have some good features for calculating the data and storing the data inside it. So first we are going to learn what is open office for Calcium. Calcium is a spreadsheet application. It is used to organize, manipulate and perform calculations on numerical data. It is used to organize means arrange, manipulate means change and perform calculations on numerical data. Like if you want to make a class result, so you can use the OpenOffice for Calcium easily to insert the data, change the data, according to the numbers the student will get in their exams, and perform the calculations of how many students get in 100%, 80%, 70%. Results on their exam. It helps to enter data, edit data, format data, perform calculations on the data, and present data in graphical form. You can also present your data in the graphical form. So here are the steps to start Calcium. First, click on the start button. Second, go to all programs. Third, search the open office. Package. Fourth is click on the Calcium application icon, so your OpenOffice for Calcium window will open. So for you, and steps here. So click on the start button, the program, search for the OpenOffice. Let's see, I have OpenOffice or not. I think I don't have OpenOffice. So, like if you don't have your OpenOffice in your computer system, you can easily download the OpenOffice from internet. Just type open office. So this is the site of the OpenOffice from where you can download your OpenOffice. Select your operating system. Select your language. Select your version. And installation. So the window will open. Your download will start shortly. Download is running. Here my OpenOffice is downloading. Okay, so the script is downloading. We move to further slides. The next slide is components of the OpenOffice 4 CLC window. Menu bar, function toolbar, formatting toolbar, format toolbar. This is the image of workbook and worksheet. When you open a new file, it's known as a workbook. The name of the workbook mentioned here. The command side field sees the sheets tab, which means the different worksheets are here inside the workbook. In each and every worksheet, there are so many rows and columns are there, and the point where the rows and columns are connecting or combining to each other is known as cell. The intersection cell. The intersection of a column and a row forms a The intersection of a column and a row forms a cell. Cell contains data in text, numbers, and formula type. A cell can contain data of a different type like text, number, formulas, date, time, etc. Column A, row 1 form the cell A1. The first cell in the worksheet is known as a A1. The name of that cell is A1. The name box is just about the worksheet given here, in which the cell address of the active cell is displayed in the name box. How to rename a worksheet? To rename a worksheet, select the worksheet which you want to rename. Right click on that. Options will open. Here you have to select rename option. And now a dialog box is open for entering your new name. To insert a new worksheet, click on the insert menu and select sheet. Or right click on its tab and select insert sheet. Right click on the sheet tab and select the sheet. Or click into an empty space at the end of the line of sheet tabs. These are the three methods given here to insert the sheet. Each method will open insert sheet dialog. For creating a new workbook, you have to go to the file option, click on the new, select spreadsheet, or you can use the control M. The new workbook window will open. Saving a file, go to file, click on the save option, or you can do control S. Now it will ask to save your file in what location do you want and what is the name of file you have to give before saving the file. The extension of CLC file is .ods. How to open a pre-saved file? So you have to go to file option, click on open, or you can just use Ctrl O option. It will ask you from where you have to open the file, select your file and click on the open. Closing CLC workbook. To close the CLC workbook, you have to go to file option and click on the exit, or you can just do Ctrl plus Q on the keyboard. To know the cell contents, there is a screen given in which text, number, and formula are here inside the cell. Inserting contents in cell, how you can insert content inside the cell. First of all, double click on the cell in which you want to insert data. This will place the content in the cell. Second step, type the required content and press enter. Third step, if you want to delete any content, press the backspace key or delete key to delete one character at a time. So Microsoft Excel is a similar application as the Kelsey. So we can do a practical on the Kelsey. If we don't have the Kelsey, we can use the Excel software instead of Kelsey software. So this is our worksheet in which this is the name box, these are the rows, columns, and these are the cells. Right here I am typing my name. Number. Calculation. So this is a formula bar where you can see the formula on print of the cell. How to select cell? To select a single cell, click it. Select multiple cells in a range, hold down the left mouse button and drag the mouse up to the selected cell. The selected cell gets highlighted. Right, if you want to select single cell, click on it. Select. You want to select the multiple cell, go to cell, press the left mouse button and drag the mouse. Then you want to select your cell. Now, editing cell content. Click the cell which needs to be edited. Press the Alt key. Press the function key, add or change the content of the cell, press enter key. Like I am about to change the name cell. So first select the cell, press the Alt key now. So it is what you want. Press enter. Moving around, if you want to move on the Excel sheet or spreadsheet, just press the arrow to move your phone. You can easily move around the sheet or from the tab button. You can move forward and shift tab, you can move backward. First step to go to next column, press enter to go to next row, press alt, press enter to enter the new name in the same column within the same cell. Alt plus enter. Like if you are here, alt plus enter. Okay. So it will work on the open office 4.3, not here. Moving and copying self content. Select the cell from which you want to move or copy the content. The content toolbar performs the following option. Or you can use Ctrl X, Ctrl C for copy and paste the data. Here, Ctrl C, here, Ctrl V, Ctrl C. Ctrl C, plus Ctrl V, copy and paste, Ctrl X and Ctrl V, cut and paste. Let's do Ctrl V. If you want to paste a cut of copy printing in the function toolbar, let's do paste a cut. Insert a column. Place the cursor in the column for which you want to add a column. Then right click. Click on insert column from the shortcut menu. At the beginning of the column, then do insert it. Right. Here is the formula, let's look at the insert. For the second row, we will put it in here. Set. Here is the set of row. Inserting the frame of cursor, we will want to add a row in the right click. Click on insert for from the menu. That appears the row will be inserted. Delete row and column. Place the cursor in the column which you want to delete and then right click and click on delete. Delete the entire row, delete the entire column. So I want to delete this column. I put the cursor in the column name, right click and delete. Formatting tools. Like change font type, font size, zoom in color on the line, left, center, right, justify, borders, background color, font color. Change font and font color. Change font, select the cell or range to be formatted. In the format toolbar, select the icon font from the font. Change font size, select the cell or color to be formatted. Select the font size from the formatting. Emphasizing text, select the cell or segments to be formatted. On the home tab in the front font group, perform the following bold, italic, underline. Okay. We want to change the font type. So, formatting toolbar and selecting the format type. Font size. Bold it with underline. With cell or cell range. The cell range. Bold italic underline. Changing font color, select cell or cell range to be formatted in the formatting toolbar. Click the arrow next to the font color button. Select the correct color. Font color and the background color of the selected cells. Cell alignment. You can also align text inside the cells by using the cell alignment. Right. top left, center left, center bottom, middle left, bottom, top, middle, bottom, left, center, right, center. So this is the middle center. Horizontal alignment, left, center, right, is this one. Vertical alignment, top, middle, bottom. Grab text quality is used to display the content in multiple and in the same place. So we'll have to apply grab text, let the cell or cell and fully formatted. Right click on the cell and select from the cell or from the cell dialog. Click on the alignment tab and click on grab text automatically. Check box. Text is getting outside from the column, so I am playing the red text here, so it will adjust the content in multiple lines inside the cell. Merge in center. For this, if you want to merge the multiple cells into a single cell, you can use the merge data centered line in center. It's a way to turn multiple cells into a larger cell and place the content in the center. Click the cell and click on the formatting toolbar, click small icon and then click on center line. If you have narrow column, you can locate the text diagonally to fit into the cell. Location of text. Select the cell or cell and see formatted. Right click on the cell and select format cell. The format cell dialog box opens from the format cell dialog box in the alignment tab. Set the diagonal angle so you can rotate the circle here, or you can just put the degree to 45 degrees, 50 degrees, 10 degrees. How much degree you want to apply on your text to rotate. Format cell means various formatting options can also be applied by right clicking on cell in selecting format cell option. Here you can select the type of the cell format, right click on the cell, click on the format cell, open the cell, here, select the required cell format, click OK. Auto sum, apply auto sum. You can see that insert a formula in the selected cell that adds the number. Click to select the cell following the line number, locate the formula bar and click on auto sum. Confirm that the selected cell has cells to be added. Table function in the is that you can get the amount by a single click using the given auto sum problem. Like I have disclosed data inserted in my sheet. So now I'm clicking on the auto sum. Automatically click the answer. You can see the formula over here. This is the formula. It's just applied on the cell range. Auto sum is always applied on the cell range. Like vertical cell range or horizontal cell range. This type of formula is shown. Hope you all will be able to use Kelsey now. If you have any question, you will ask me. Phone number, WhatsApp.